I think about this world that we're giving to my daughter. I think about it daily. I think about it hourly. I've got a new kid. There's a sense of urgency now. And as admittedly cool and interesting as it's going to be for her in the future when she's older to be able to say, well, you know, I lived in the prequel to The Handmaid's Tale. I just don't think it's a good trade-off. And, you know, I do a lot of press for these shows, and there seems to be a general misconception that people have where people will be like, boy, I know Trump sucks, but he must be the gift that keeps on giving for a comic, huh? No, it's quite the opposite. For a couple reasons. One is there's no reveal, you know? There's no, like, there's no joking made, like, well, look who turned out to be a real dick, you know? The guy, he is who he is. He was always that person. He's always an awful, reprehensible, shitty con man. You can't make fun of you can't do a Trump bit, in other words. Like that, I had a bit when he said the shithole countries thing. That was pretty good. Made a point. It was like 3 minutes long. And then, you know, about 14 days later, people are like, what are you talking about? That happened 6 years ago, right? Because there's no permanence to it. Every awful, outrageous, egregious thing he says is supplanted within an hour by something even more awful, outrageous, and egregious. And making fun of Trump is like making fun of the way a kaleidoscope looks right now, you know? It's pointless. There's no permanence to it. And I know there's a lot of speculation as to, you know, how will Trump leave office, you know? Will he serve out a full term, or will he be forced to resign in shame, or will he serve out two full terms, or three or four at the rate we're going? Or will he be arrested and sent to federal prison for treason, or will he die of a massive coronary on a golden toilet, or will he be assassinated by a group of caring nuns? Or will he succumb to the polonium laced tea? Or will he be ripped apart by four horses going in different directions in the town square, as long as we're gonna keep going back to medieval days? Or will he be shot by a Nazi who travels through time to shoot Trump going, you're making us look bad? Or will that time-traveling Nazi be thwarted by a time-traveling Richard Nixon who travels through time just past the Nazi so he can land there so when the Nazi shows up, he can shoot the Nazi going, please, please, for my sake, let him live, you know? Or will he die of third-degree burns and shrapnel when the polygraph machine explodes? Or will he die of a perforated colon when Tucker Carlson and Sean Hannity and Piers Morgan and Devin Nunes and Paul Ryan and Mitch McConnell and Paul Rand and all the Foxen pals all try to mount him simultaneously? We don't know.